man, you're listening to Dark Skies Podcast coming to you live from Los Angeles, California, where all the news happened. But in Chicago, man, I don't know, man. My people are telling me it's crazy. But fake news, got the media going crazy. Jesse Smollett got some explaining to do. Okay, man. Look at fake news, fake media, fake news stories, fake beatdown, all kinds of just stuff to make you think. So light them if you got them, strap yourself in. You found Dark Skies Podcast coming to you live, as usual, from the City of Angels. Alright, be right back. Get it going here, 2019, huh? We're in season 4 of Dark Skies Podcast. Whole crew together as we grow to try to make more sense of the senseless. And nothing more senseless than, you know, people who make things up. You know, bad people, liars. You know, fake people, people who like attention. Attention grabbers. Look at me. You know, I'm a victim. And today's reality, you know, being a victim is good for business. You know, with albums coming out and, you know, my face all on TV. You know, what else can I do, you know, to keep my name, my face in circulation? Well, a lot of people do many things to try to accomplish these feats. You know, some things are good. You know, they may go feed the homeless or go hand out some turkeys on Thanksgiving. Maybe they'll, you know, open up an orphanage or maybe a school, you know. And some people, you know, come up with a plan, a scheme, an idea. What that you can do to make people look. You know, look at me. It's look at me time. Well, welcome to Dark Skies Podcast. And we're going to get today started. I'm your host, Tennessee Graves. I can actually definitely be good. Jim helping out with the sound levels. And Jennifer doing the music today. It's funny because we usually don't do shows on tabloid or rumors or anything that's, you know, Hollywood-like. But this is like a Hollywood script. When I look at this Jesse Smollett story, it's incredible. I mean, we have an actor, right? This guy is, you know, pretty popular, I guess, if you watch the show Empire. You know, Jesse Smollett is one of the actors, you know, reoccurring actors on the show. So we are a little bit familiar with him. You know, some of us brothers and sisters, you know, who watch the show. Now me, I don't get to watch the show too often because I have a life. So I don't have time to sit in front of a TV and watch Jesse's acting skills. But it's funny because reports are coming in all over the place that the young man was attacked. He had his ass whooped. Now, usually I don't make fun of people getting their ass whooped. Well, actually, I do. I mean, because it happens so often, you know. I'm from Compton, so I see ass whoopings, you know, quite often. So I'm quite familiar with, you know, people catching unexpected ass whoopings. Matter of fact, I can do a show on unexpected ass whoopings alone. But I digress. I want to understand what would go through a man's mind and make a man think that, you know, I need to, you know, stage my own ass kicking. Now, I done heard a lot of things, you know, from the Mandela effect, strange reality switches, you know, the crazy stuff going on with our government shutting down, opening walls were trying to be built, crazy president going through crazy Senate, going through crazy reactions from, you know, crazy Americans. I just call it all crazy because that's basically what it is to me. You know, this doesn't make any sense, but this Jesse Smollett story. I mean, it just caught my attention because, well, you have no choice but to, you know, hear about it because it's all over the news. You know, ABC is reporting on it. Fox is reporting on it. KFI reporting on it. All of our friends, you know, on iHeart. You know, it's covering it because, you know, Jesse Smollett is, you know, like a Hollywood actor, you know. And here in California, you know, he's one of the, you know, mainstays. And people, you know, they support each other here in California, you know. They don't want, you know, you to feel like you're alone, especially after something like an attack or some type of, you know, injury or accident may have befallen you. And, you know, people reach out, you know, with good wishes and feelings, and, you know, they stand up for you. Well, a lot of people stood up for Jesse because he was attacked, but not just attacked, but he was attacked by people that was, you know, screaming out homophobic slurs and, you know, calling them horrible names and, you know, banging Trump. You know, this is MAGA. You know, they had a MAGA hat on. I got a MAGA hat. You see this? Make America great again. In case you don't know what MAGA means. So it's incredible when you start to hear the story when it first came out. You know, it was all over the media. You know, ABC, all these places couldn't wait to report. You know that, you know, Trump supporters, you know, beat up Empire actor, you know, openly gay actor. And, you know, for some of you that don't know this guy, you know, he openly, you know, tells the world that he's gay. Now, it's weird to me because, you know, people who are heterosexual don't walk around and say, I'm heterosexual. I'm openly heterosexual. So it always makes me wonder when somebody wants to announce that, you know, that I'm in, you know, show business and I'm openly gay. But, you know, I guess everybody has their reasons for doing it. Well, it looks like Jesse may have alternate motives for telling the whole world that he's gay. I guess he wants to get more attention. You know, he wants more support from the gay community. And the gay community do support the actors, singers, rappers. And that's great. It's beautiful. But Jesse, you know, needed more than that support. He needed, you know, the support from the rest of the world. You know, he wanted to, you know, the victim support, the support that says that, you know, I've been attacked, wrongly attacked, and, you know, by Trump. You know, he sent his goons to get me. And you see how bad, you know, Trump is. You know, it became a political statement, you know, this gentleman attacked, you know, by these horrible, horrible, mean MAGA hat wearing, you know, Republicans, I guess you would call them, or white men, as they were first reported. Yeah, I was like, oh my God, you know, he got a rope hung around his neck and, you know, he's a black man. And that's what I was thinking about. But they were took it to a whole nother level saying that, you know, nah, he was, you know, pressured and attacked and beaten and, you know, and they hung a rope around his neck and threatened him, you know. So I was like, wow. So as time went by, more parts of the story started to leak about, who did it, and there's no images and there's no, evidence of a white man even in the area. And there's just two dudes that did come up on some of the cameras, but they were like, they didn't fit the description that was given. But still, they're wanted for questioning. And next thing nobody knew who these dudes were, or they were just two blurry images, at least to the world. So, Jesse still had, good, word with the community. Everybody was like, this is messed up, what happened? And by this time he was back in California and he was talking to the public and doing, events and, so forth. So as time went by, we was like, wow, this is really, really strange. But it just had too many holes in the story. Like, why would you go out so late to go eat at Subway? I mean, Subway makes some okay sandwiches because they make them right there in front of you. Yeah, pretty good. But I ain't finna go get one about 2 something in the morning. Well, I guess I could, because ain't nobody finna beat my ass anywhere. And if so, then I guess I deserve to have my ass whooped being at the wrong place at the wrong time. I grew up in an area where, unexpected ass whoopings, happen all the time. So, I'm not gonna be wandering around, but this guy, this openly gay actor, I'm openly gay and I'm an actor, so my face is all on TV, and I'm gonna walk around at 2 in the morning to a Subway, in an area where, I might run into some angry Republicans. So I don't know, these stories just make you wonder as they come from all these different angles, and it becomes, this man got attacked and had a rope hung around his neck by white men to, no, it was politically motivated, and they were threatening him. So I'm like, oh man, such a swamp, man. So now the story gets deeper. So we're gonna take a quick break, light them if you got them, because man, we're talking fake ass news, fake attacks, and why? We'll be right back. You're listening to the Dark Skies Podcast, live from Los Angeles, California. We should just get drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk. Girl, we should just get drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk. Life is great when you're naked. You press the gas and I break it. I drink liquor, don't chase it. And I get women, don't chase them. I put a face in the pillow and watch her bite on the blanket. See you tempted to taste it. Get every drop and don't waste it. I'm fucking with you. I'm fucking with you. The type of dick to make a white girl say, I love that nigga. I hit your Instagram and click like on like every picture. You get it from your mama, well, and bring your mama with you. And lots of liquor. Tell her, fuck me like you hate me. You love me, I say, maybe. She say, boy, don't keep me waiting. I say, go down, don't be lazy, yeah. Now that's my baby, that's my baby. She love me from my drive, I love her cause she drive me crazy. What's up? More rest and sex is all a nigga needs. And a lifetime of stress, trying to put my mind at ease. I'm not looking at the phone, too much shipping going on. But while we got this moment of peace alone, girl, we should just get drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk. Girl, we should just get drunk and fuck, drunk. Yeah, drunk and fuck, drunk. OVO, I ride. OMO, I ride. Reps hooked at my niggas from the Scarborough side. Don't fuck with them, my hollow tips will fly. I don't have to lie. Lot of people say it in a song just to say it, man. I'm not that type of guy. Hit me on the cell. I just might bring you to the city, send you home with stories you can never tell. I'm trying to break you out of your shell. You just turned 21 like Adele, that's good with me. I put my business on hold. Let me turn off the phone. Let's explore the unknown. If you're not drinking with me, you force me to turn up alone. No peer pressure, I just know you like to get in your zone. You say that you rather smoke. Well, let me call up Obie's room and tell him roll up a cone. I know he probably got that extra special. I never second guess it. How's Villanova? What classes you taking next semester? Man, she like, fuck the small talk. I'm not here to discuss extra credits of my professors. No time for funny stories. It's funny how she shows up late but always comes before me. We both young and misguided, but that's another story. Yeah.
More rest and sex is all a nigga needs. And a lifetime of stress trying to put my mind at ease. I'm not looking at the phone, too much shit been going on. But while we got this moment of peace alone, girl, we should just get
drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk.
Girl, we should just get
drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk.
Girl, we should just get.
We should just get drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk and fuck, drunk.
What a crazy, crazy, crazy weekend. But we following all these crazy stories and trying to figure out what's going on. Man, I was just wondering that, how do you get to the point where you go to hire somebody to beat your ass? I mean, you know, how do you get to that point? And if you are opening a new company and you want to go into business, you know, how do you go into business of beating people's ass and getting paid for it? Like, you know, I mean, I'm going to be happy to beat your ass, but I'm going to need my money up front. I don't know, man. I mean, how do you hire somebody to do this? I mean, do you put out an ad, or do you just, you know, hire amongst friends and family, or, you know, keep the, you know, the money in house, or do you venture out and, you know, because a stranger will beat your ass, you know, indiscriminately. So maybe you'll want a better ass whooping, you know, from a stranger. Or do you even think about, you know, race or creed or gender when you are looking to hire somebody to beat your ass? I mean, what do you actually, you know, what are the procedures, and, you know, what do you actually have to have go through in your mind, you know, to put yourself mentally in a position to say, I need my ass kicked and I need to find somebody to do it. But not just somebody. I need two people, you know, because I want this ass whooping to be good. You know, I want this ass whooping to be so good that everybody in the world is going to feel bad for me. And this is going to help my career. This ass whooping is going to help me move forward in all of my dreams and aspirations. I mean, it's a special ass kicking. So you're looking for somebody to fulfill these needs. So you are searching. I don't know, man. I'm just trying to get into the mind, you know, of, you know, Jesse. What the hell was he thinking? Now, it's funny because multiple sources have told, you know, reporters over at ABC, 7, Eyewitness News, that the police are investigating whether Smollett and his two friends staged the alleged attack, because Smollett is being written off as, you know, as a victim. Like, he ain't no victim, you know. That's what the police is, you know, basically saying right now. When before they were, you know, singing a different tune, they're like, oh, he's a victim. He's a victim. You know, somebody did this. He's a victim. You know, we're not saying he's not a victim. You know, that's what the police was definitely, you know, wanted the world to understand. You know, the Chicago police don't want to be looking like they're not taking it seriously. So Chicago police confirmed this past Thursday that detectives were talking to the two men that, you know, that we saw as blur on the cameras that came out, you know, over the last few days. But now it turns out, you know, it's these two dudes, you know, these two dudes that allegedly attacked, you know, Jesse. But multiple sources said that the police were investigating whether Smollett and these two men had staged the attack allegedly because Smollett was being written off of Empire, and he needed something to, you know, spark interest and make it you know, almost impossible for the Empire writers to, you know, write his ass up out of here, you know, like the Thanos snap, you know, dust his ass up off the show. But, you know, can't do that if he just got his ass whooped. I guess that was his plan. But it's crazy because people who are familiar with the investigation said that Smollett failed to appear for an interview with the detectives. And that was earlier Thursday. You know, because the police were asking for his phone. They wanted to look at his phone because he was saying that when he was attacked, he was talking to his manager. You know, the lie meter, right? The lie meter go off. Like, we need to see your phone. You know, make sure he was talking to your manager or whoever you say he was talking to. He's like, oh, no, you can't see my phone. I got other numbers. What you mean, other numbers? You know, what, you got Putin's number in your phone? What number, you know, who you got in your phone that you're scared to hand your phone over to the police that are investigating your ass whooping? I don't know, man. But they were saying that the Chicago police superintendent, and this man, Eddie Johnson, that he contacted ABC himself to say that they're continuing to treat Smollett as a victim and the investigation remains ongoing. But they want to talk to him, you know, Smollett. You need to come in, man. We need to re-interview you, talk about what you told us. Because you told us that you got attacked by two white men and we got two black men. And not just that we got two black men, they were the only two men that were in the area and they admit being in an area. And not only do they admit being in an area, they admit knowing you. And, you know, we just went on to say, we finna, you know, hit you with these crimes. You know, you did this. And they're like, you know, okay, yeah, we did. But he paid us to do it. He wanted us to beat his ass. You know, we committed this attack, you know, as a job. We were paid to do it. And, well, that just opened a whole new can of worms. Because now police are wondering, did the attack even happen at all after the attack happened? Was it staged? You know? So Smollett released a statement Thursday saying that, you know, he did answer the follow-up questions. And he continued to cooperate and he would be in to, you know, meet with the detectives and, you know, talk about what happened. But this has not happened. And since then, he's hired attorneys and shit. And some people are saying that, you know, he was being written off of Empire. And this is just a whole big publicity stunt, you know, to save his career, his dying career, the dying career of a bad actor. The idea that Jesse Smollett, you know, was attacked and was being written off of Empire and the news media latching onto the story and it be turned, you know, it turning into a political, you know, mass media circus and people, you know, remain skeptical, you know, as the story becomes more and more apparent that it was some lies, man, being told by one Jesse. And now, you know, these dudes are facing charges. They're rolling over saying, hey, you know, we did beat his ass, but, you know, at his request. I don't know, man. It sounds like a bunch of fake news, fake stories, and a bunch of lies, and, you know, one bad actor's bad attempt to save face. So, I don't know, man. We're going to take a quick break. Light them if you get them. You're listening to Dark Skies Podcast, brought to you by Direct Connect Plumbing. Man, live from Los Angeles, California. We'll be right back, y'all. This is so crazy.
I'm gonna tell you this right now. If you woke up this morning, nigga, you winning. For real. Yeah. I got a big amount. I took a different route. I am the pickle, the little. I was a juvie, gave me community, I had to pick up some little. I want it easy, please do not tease me, I want my Yeezy to dinner. This is the season, I got the season, don't make me sprinkle you niggas. I got my reason, you wanna please me, send me the pussy, not pictures. Met her this week and fuck her this evening, and she tryna freak on the liquor. Yeah, I am a boss on these bitches, yeah. I post some boss on these bitches, yeah. I have no thoughts on these bitches, yeah. Rocked up across on these bitches, yeah. Dealer departed, gala today. On some Prince shit, you know what they say. Me and my safe got a friendship. 10 on me, thin weight, flip weight, getting paid, getting late. Bitch made, took off 6 days, 6 tray, 6 4, bounce, bitch, bounce. Hood nigga, favorite spot was the Whopper House. Patty melt with the hash brown, trying to avoid all the pat downs, trying to avoid all the lane hole. Weirdos in the background, blackout when I back out. Blow the horn for a pedestrian, show the ride like an equestrian. I bought the dress that she in, red bottoms in his and hers. Got a rollie in his and hers, got a car in his and hers. Walk in the zoo and say pick a fur, last night was a blur to me. This morning I had two with me, I don't know what to do with me. Going ape like the zoo with me, got a tool with a screw missing. Two girls in the pool kissing, everywhere I go the ride with me. Cutting niggas acting too fishy,
Fuck y'all niggas on, man. Duffel bag forever. Just left V Live. Atlanta could never die long as Tit alive. Yeah. Look, I got a big amount. I think I'm the biggest out. Got hits and I ain't even put them out. Lit and you can't even put it out. Got the Billboard melodies. Rapping something I do on the side. Crossed over to the other side. And I didn't even have to die. Got the money and I never show it. Let a nigga try and play heroic. Michael Jackson talking to me in my dreams, and he say you bad and you know it. Better Shimon on my check then. I'm a J Prince investment. Niggas love to talk reckless. They see me like best friends. Got the sand color FN. And I never seen the inside of a Marriott or a West End. 5 stars, nothing less than. Fuck niggas on your payroll. And you let them know the safe code. And you knew them for a month though. But you call them niggas big bro. You can move in and hitting hills, and we still don't live by the same code. I'm respected everywhere I go. Nigga long live bankroll. Skip the rainbow, funny style shit, and straight to the pot of gold. Somebody, everybody know. 6 God with the God flow. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Back on Dark Skies, y'all. Yeah, and we're covering the senseless today. We're talking fake news stories, old lying ass Jesse. And what is the reason for this story anyway? Why the media latched on, and why is this even, you know, in people's, you know, mind, you know? Because everything from my friends over in Chicago is telling me that, you know, this motherfucker set himself up, you know, to get his ass kicked. But now, you know, he set himself up to maybe even go to jail because the Chicago PD don't play when it comes to filing a false police report. Now, I don't know no motherfucker who would do it anyway, but, you know, my understanding from my friends over in Chicago is that you file a false police report, that shit is like a felony. So you can actually go to jail for this. So police are going to want to talk to this guy. And they already released the two dudes. And his lawyer was, you know, out there banging. Telling him, my dudes are walking away. You know, she's feeling good. You know, she getting paid. And it's funny because this is how stupid Jesse is. He paid these motherfuckers, right, to kick his ass. They get caught. They tell him. Now, he could probably go to jail for paying these motherfuckers to kick his ass. And the money that he paid these motherfuckers to kick his ass is being used on an attorney to get them out of trouble for kicking his ass. I'm sorry, that was a lot, but, you know, this is one man in his reality, in his perception of his reality. Man, we're just on the outside looking in, you know, taking it all in. Law officials told ABC News and Fox News and anybody else who would listen that, you know, homes of the person of interest were raided Wednesday night. You know, police removed shoes, electronic devices, and other items believed, you know, could help them determine, you know, the two people who played any role in the assault of said actor. Now, this guy, you know, no damn well ain't nobody heard him, you know, that, you know, like, regularly. Now, I always say that unexpected ass whoopings come all the time, you know. I live in a city where, you know, shit happens. You know, just road rage, you know, can cause you to get your ass kicked, you know, at any time here in Los Angeles, Compton, Watts, Inglewood, you know, surrounding area, you know. So people understand, you know, that ass whoopings happen. I was walking in the alley, he said. Car stopped. Told me, you know, go inside the house. This dude, man, he just lies, man. And he just, you know, he talk about the white dudes that attacked him, but the two dudes that the police released were Nigerian. You know, the brothers that grew up, you know, together, and, you know, they described that they were friends with, you know, this actor. We know him. Matter of fact, one of them claimed to even be his trainer as he got ready for his music video. Oh, his album was about to drop, too. I mean, it's a lot going on here, right? But it's funny because police released these dudes. No charges were filed. Police reported that, you know, these guys are no longer, you know, persons of interest as far as, like, you know, suspects. Now the police are changing their investigation. Because as soon as these dudes get off the airplane, you know, O'Hare International Airport, they were picked up. My guess is they came back, you know, because they were persons of interest in on film. And they saw that. And they're like, you know what, we don't want them looking for us. We need to come back and explain that we were paid to do what we did. Which was outlandish to hear when you first hear it. But as the evidence started to come in, receipts and, and relationships are starting to come out. And then, you know, this guy, Jesse, I guess he's not cooperating, right? He's not coming in. He's not talking to the police. And these dudes are, you know, happily talking to the police. Matter of fact, one would say they're turning over. Now Jesse got some explaining to do. And all of this is wasting people's time because people are looking at this story like it's important. And, you know, the real important news is, you know, our climate and what's going on with our damn weather. And you need to explain what's happening there and why the hell we're freezing. And, you know, are we in a new ice age? Instead, we got to worry about this motherfucker getting his ass kicked. I tell you one thing, man. So many fights happen all over the world, all over the country, all over this city. And this is news. Wow. But we're going to talk a little bit more about it when we get back. So light him if you got him. You're listening to Dark Skies Podcast, coming to you live from Los Angeles, California. California.
The good kid. Tired of doing it the same way, gotta flip it before I ruin it. Make it all make sense before you put your toe in it. Opinions get thrown out the window with rhyme brows, so turn me up loud so the world can hear. And when your favorite rapper rapping, you should cover your ears and go death. Go death, I said. Go death to stay dead. A shot to the forehead to kill him. But I ain't here for no ignorance. I'm militant as Martin Luther King in a penalty. Aiming for my dream till a bullet bounce off one of my deep thoughts and hit a nigga in the spleen. I got it in my jeans. You probably think I'm talking about a pistol, but I'm talking about the blood of a warrior. My nigga, what you worry for? I ain't trying to jack your swag. I'm trying to better my craft and stay relevant. Yeah.
As time flies, time flies. Go dead, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Far from the boring, the boring.
I'd rather you call me that
than the typical artist you call whack on a YouTube blog holding 8 hours and stacks of ones, but never can be the one to rally communities or lead a crowd of blacks. Passion is too strong. I'm pissed off, so it's the chance you get pissed on. R. Kelly was in the wrong, but that'll make you an exempt. That'll make you a no-go from hitting the fence. You ain't a bloody damn show, you ain't a crip, the crowd yell. But I ain't a pimp, I'm me, I'm free, it's a 5-finger discount. See you on the flip side, right after I dismount. If I ever feel like I ain't pushing myself, I find a cliff, then push myself off the edge. Like a barber at the tip of your head, that's how I settle it. Life or death if I ain't relevant. Nickel.
As time flies, hope that I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Far from the boring, the boring. Should die before I wake. I pray my music could take my place. The world, the world, the world, the world, the relevant.
So feel free to not mind me if you're used to boosters, drug dealers, and shooters on wax. Cause most of y'all niggas fabricate facts anyway. I could easily cheat and let the 4-4 play like a 2-2 orgy. But I've been there and it bores me. Got to the point where it did nothing for me. At 40, I wanna afford not to record bullshit in my story. And I'm mad young, so I'd rather do it now before my career's done. This is pain plus glory. Victory is here. If I cry, you can see strength and pride in my tears. I do it for the kids. I do it for the 23. Howard Lockdown's doing time in the pen, and my pen is the only thing I got for hip hop to change the game. If they'll remember my name as the relevant.
As time flies,
yeah, I want you to punch me in my eye and punch me in my jaw as hard as you can. And the force of your punch should knock me off my feet and take me to the ground, but use the rope around my neck to make sure that it kind of chokes me some when I fall. And the moment I hit the ground, I need this to happen. I need this to happen. I need both of you to join in and stomp me across my chest. You know, my chest. As hard as you can, stomp down on my chest. Yes, I'm gonna pay you. I'm gonna pay you. I'm sorry. I'm just trying to figure out how the conversation went. You know, as they, you know, planned and orchestrated and and rehearsed this ass whooping that, you know, Jesse so happily took. And it was funny because I figured that if Jesse is arrested for, you know, filing this fake police report, that, you know, if he do spend any time in jail, that, you know, that he quickly do push-ups, because ass whoopings happen a lot in jail. I mean, people get their ass whipped, you know, just trying to get breakfast in the shower. And, you know, I don't know. It sounds like a bad place to be if you don't like violence. But maybe you do like violence because you actually pay for it. And that's strange in itself. And I'm pretty sure there's plenty of people in jail that would be happy to take your money and beat your ass. You know, it's like right up the alley. Yeah. I'm sorry, man. I ain't trying to make fun of it, but yeah, man, what else can I do, man? Can't get angry. I mean, I didn't get my ass kicked. So, you listening to Dark Skies Podcast? Man, be right back.
That's a vibe. Yeah. That's a vibe. It's a vibe. That's a vibe, yeah, yeah, yeah. That's a vibe, oh, it's a vibe, and that's a vibe, yeah. That's a vibe, she want a vibe. That's a vibe, yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. that's a vibe. She wanna vibe, that's a vibe. It's a vibe, yeah, yeah, late night. Oh, it's a vibe, let me slide. Oh, it's a vibe, yeah, yeah. Dim the lights. Oh, it's a vibe, yeah. Get high, it's a vibe. Oh, it's a vibe, yeah.
It's a vibe, don't you lie. Your pussy drippin', gushin', drippin' down your thighs. It's a vibe, get high. Digging deep while I'm looking in your eyes. Vibe is the realest. I know you feel it. It's a vibe, different vibe. It's my vibe, nigga.
Okay, so I got the ambience, just where I want it. And if you get paid, it's solely based on your performance. My ego is enormous, like my crib in California. If you ain't got no heart, man, you're gonna need a donor. Now I said I'm from the corner of the ATL. Well, we got that clientele, avoid paper trails. Broke so many bills down that I'm shell shocked. A hell Glock sold rocks by the mailbox. Got a vibe, make a young chick turn the neck. Got a vibe, make a cougar wanna spend a check. Got a vibe, make a Asian wanna botch. Got a vibe, make a Italian want Versace. Carbon copies get declined, I'm the pioneer. Beat that pussy up, I need riot gear. Any volunteers, gas in a Ziploc. Now that's loud and clear, this one out of here. This is our year.
That's a vibe, that's a vibe. That's a vibe. That's a vibe, yeah, yeah. That's a vibe. It's a vibe. It's a vibe. That's a vibe, yeah, yeah. It's a vibe. Am I your type? Pussy tight. Maybe I'll spend the night, yeah, yeah. That's a vibe. What's it, like? That's the type of shit I like, yeah, yeah. That's a vibe. It's a vibe. That's a vibe. Oh, it's a vibe, yeah, yeah. It's a vibe, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Can I get to do it? It was about 3 in the morning. You know, I'm an openly gay black man. I mean, just go walk defensively out on the street and see if I can get my ass kicked. I don't know, man. It's a crazy world we live in. People are suffering from some type of mental deficiency where they do anything for attention, trying to get people to look, even if it means being a fake victim of your own attack. And now you're a victim of your own mistake. So, you know, is that karma? That's the instant karma. You know, you pay for an ass kicking and you get it. And then you go to jail for it. Go to jail for your own assault. So it's crazy how the world works, but the world works. Oh, man, it is what it is, man. So I've tackled this subject long enough, but I do want to tell y'all that stuff like this distracts from reality, from real shit that's really happening. You know, the government, you know, is in a state of an emergency because of a wall that they want to build. I mean, we got the government going at each other. We got crazy weather situations and, you know, should be state of emergency and places in the world that, you know, need actual attention. I mean, we live our day-to-day lives to the best of our ability, but we're forced to be showered with such useless information like this asshole. And, you know, I mean, even if he was really attacked, I mean, it shouldn't have been such a huge story, but I guess it is. And now it's an even huger story because he seemed to have set this up himself. Now, I'm not saying nothing if he did or didn't. I could really care less. I mean, because, like I said, I've seen people get their ass beat just in traffic. So I know that, you know, unexpected ass whoopings happen all the time. I mean, it's just a part of life when you live amongst so many people. And some people are happy, some people are not. So kind of crazy. But it is what it is. But I'm your host, L.C. Graves. Thank you. Becky was on the side. Becky was like, oh, he did him because he was gay. And I took, I don't know, man. See, look, she's mad at me because, she, hey, I mean, this dude is a different type of dude. I've never seen nothing like this, to be honest with you. And, you know, this is what life is like, you know, when you live enough days, you start to see things you've never seen before. And this is definitely something I've never seen before. And poor Becky, she's something. He made it bad for people who really get attacked and really get go through, you know, problems in society. Now when they come out and say that they got attacked or they got treated wrongly or unfairly, people are gonna look at them as, you know, sideways eye because of this asshole, you know, what he tried to pull. But, you know, we'll see. Only time will tell. It does seem like it's instant karma. All right, y'all. Talk to you soon.